Climate scientists have noticed a very disturbing trend when it comes to our oceans warming up and our coral reefs being bleached. Now, this is an event that's happened 3 times in history, and according to the reports, the ultimate result could be the loss of more than 12,000 square kilometers, or over 4,500 square miles of coral this year, with particularly strong impacts in Hawaii and other U.S. tropical regions and potentially continuing into 2016. So basically what happens is the water is so warm that the coral reef is not can't adapt to it, isn't evolved to deal with it. So as a result, the color changes, it's not getting the nutrients necessary to survive, and it dies off. This has happened 2 times before, once in 1998 and another time in 2010. So this is all very recent. And usually it lasts for about 1 year. But unfortunately, this recent instance began last year, and scientists are believing that it could last up to 2 years. So we don't know what kind of an impact it could have.
So a couple of things that are amazing in the story. One, science for the win always. The first time that it happened in 1998, people were caught off guard by it. They're like, whoa, this never happened before in our lifetime. So what in the world is this thing? So what do they do? Hashtag science. Okay? And they try to figure it out, and they do. So this summer, they predicted ahead of time that this was going to happen again, and then it started.
Yes.
I love that. God, I love that. You know, that's facts, right? So there's a lot of propaganda in the political world. There's a lot of, you know, mythology in the religious world. In science, there's fact, mm-hmm. right? And they're like, here's what leads to, if the ocean gets this warm, it will lead to bleaching of the corals, and then this will happen. And then that's exactly what happened, because the scientists aren't kidding. It's not an ideology, okay? So that's what the other side will say. Oh, these scientists, 97% of the world scientists have gotten together in a global conspiracy, mm-hmm. and they're interested in money. No, 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 they're interested in facts. That's why they predict things ahead of time and as it happens. And they're showing you stuff, and then you go, I don't want to see it because I get paid by the oil companies. Well, this is happening. It's a fact, right? Now, amazing facts that I did not know. 1/4 of all the life in the oceans are around corals, mm-hmm. okay? So they feed off the algae that's in the coral, etc. 1/4 of all sea life is centered around the corals. If the corals get bleached like this, the algae is off the coral,
yes.
right? And so then the life is sucked away from there, mm-hmm. right? And I'm obviously oversimplifying here, but and if they stay bleached for longer, they're more likely to die off.
Yes.
Well, then the life forms that were around the corals are gone. That then affects the other life forms in the ocean, and you spin further into danger.
Right, it has a ripple effect. And this, in addition to the acidification of the oceans, is a complete and utter disaster. I mean, if you're enjoying your sushi now, you're not going to be enjoying it for much longer if we don't change our habits. Because the CO2 levels are so high that the ocean is warming, it's already having an impact on sea life, and nothing's being done about it. And remember, there have only been 3 cases. 1998, 2010, and today. It's going to happen more and more often, and it's going to last longer each time it happens.
There are over 1 million species that live on coral reefs. Okay, 1 million species. And 1 in every 4 species of fish live on a coral reef. That's the fact I was just alluding to. And if you don't care about the fish, and you say, oh, man, you're one of those guys, like, save the humans. Yeah, who cares about Nemo? I don't need to find him, right? Okay, great. First of all, you're an idiot. Okay, second of all, it also affects the food and livelihood of 500 million people on the planet. So if you care about the humans, you'd also care about the coral reef. We are damaging this planet in an unprecedented way. This is just one of many signs. If you don't want to see the signs, you're choosing not to see evil, hear evil, right? Mm-hmm. But that evil still exists. And sometimes this is what it does. And then it affects an enormous amount of people on the planet. So we have got to learn, and we have got to adjust, and we've got to actually believe in things called facts, not on propaganda and not on ideology.